Dear viewer, good evening and welcome to Spotlight. With me tonight, Michelle Richard. She is the CEO or the founder of Great Lakes Woman Business Council. Michelle, welcome to MEA.
Thank you so much. I'm glad to be here.
Thank you. Tell me about yourself. Where do you grow up? Which school do you go?
Well, I grew up in Berkeley, Michigan.
Uh-huh.
And I went to Berkeley High School and went on to University of Michigan, where I have both an undergraduate degree and a master's degree in social work.
Oh, social work, okay. So what was your first job?
My first job was waiting tables in an Italian restaurant.
Good.
I liked it because I like getting paid every 20 minutes as people left the table.
That's right. And you did that during going to the school?
Yes, in the summers.
I see. Okay. When you established, and you are the founder.
Yes.
When did you establish the Great Lakes Woman Business Council?
I established that just before I finished graduate school in July of 1984, dating myself.
Wow, a long time ago. Yeah. What's about 40 years old?
40 years old this year. We're celebrating our 40th anniversary.
I see. And what was the reason of establishing this?
I realized through my education that the best way that I could support the community and my purpose was to help create and build small businesses among women and minorities as a way to create economic wealth, sustainability, community strength, and just in a sense help the world a little better.
After 40 years, what do you add now? How many members you have?
Oh my goodness.
Yes.
We have 2,000 plus members. We service over 2,000 small businesses a year.
Wow. That's the whole state of Michigan.
Yes.
Good. Okay. And what kind of service you give them right now?
Well, what's interesting about us is that we really focus on growing small businesses. And not just training to get into business, because there's so many organizations and universities, community colleges that do that. We focus on creating growth and sustainability. So we provide financing. Okay. We have a small business loan
fund
that we make.
That's very, very important. Okay, financing, because that's a lot of major, small business, they cannot continue and they close down because of the finance.
Absolutely, and banks generally categorize small businesses under 2 years old as startups.
Okay.
And that's okay for us. We're good with that. And so we make loans to those who cannot get conventional financing.
How you get the loans? From the bank or your organization?
No. We have the money.
You have the money. You have a grant?
We have both borrowed funds and loan and granted funds from the state and the federal government. We have two loan officers, and the application process is primarily online, but they meet with you and talk to you ahead of time.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. And we're trying to make more and more loans, so
I see.
We welcome people to apply.
I see. Eastern small business, what kind of small business? Are we talking mom and pop stores? Are we talking about the gas station and restaurant and stores? Tell me more. Because for our viewer, they want to know. And a lot of our viewer in Michigan and nationwide, woman-owned is something that exists in us.
Yes.
So a lot of people, they put their business and their wife or their sisters or, you know.
Yes. We service all kinds of businesses from the full range that you talked about.
Tell me examples.
Restaurants, light manufacturing, different professional services, everything from construction to accounting services, the wide gamut at any time. We have probably 100 businesses or more in our loan portfolio at any given time.
I see. That's including, for example, gas station. And, as you know, the Middle Eastern, 10 years ago, we were very concentrated in party stores and gas station, but thanks God, we came here for a better future for our children. They send the kids to the school, and now we have thousands of doctors and attorneys and CPAs and all that. So, and a lot of them, I could say 90%, they are involved in a small business.
Right.
Do you think they'll be qualified?
Yes. I will tell you that for investments that require millions of dollars. We don't do that. Our loan funds go up to $250,000.
That's good. You know, that's, you know, if somebody, for example, we want to extend. He's got a restaurant and he want to expand.
Exactly.
You know, he
wanna,
and this is honestly, today, the bank, they don't want to hear about finance and giving the loan. And when the interest rate is going, you know, a lot of people, you know, are staying away from that too.
Well, ours is a set interest rate, and it's much lower than the banks, especially for businesses without 100% collateral and all of and track record in that.
Yes.
That sets us apart, definitely. The other is banks are very cautious about having too many of a certain kind of company in their portfolio.
Mm-hmm.
So if they already have quite a few restaurants, they're not going to look at it. If
exactly.
they have a lot of gas stations, they're not going to look at it.
Yes.
But we're going to look at businesses based on, will this benefit the community, and not do we have too many of those dry cleaners or, you know, carpet cleaners or construction or whatever. We're looking at what the community needs.
Honestly, this community, especially, you know, COVID came.
Yes.
And create COVID, thanks God, is gone, almost gone. But there's a lot of problem, a lot of problem. A lot of business owners, they lost their business.
Yes.
Because COVID closing for almost a year, year and a half. They closed their business. They lost their business, you know. And now they're trying to come back and revive, and an organization like you could help them. You know what? It'll be great. Yeah. Michelle, tell me, we're going to talk about the gala on September 25th. But do you have, like, a monthly event that your member could come to that event and hear about the new things that you offer and all that? Tell me more.
We don't have the bandwidth to have monthly events, to
okay.
be honest.
I see.
We have very intentional events, and we do have several a year.
Okay.
We have two things going on in September. We're celebrating our 40th anniversary on September 23rd
okay.
at Suburban Collection Showplace. And that's a chance to both network with small businesses, learn more about our organization, and frankly it's very inspiring and
okay.
uplifting. But we also, on the 24th and 25th of September, have our Women's Business Conference, also at the Suburban Collection Showplace.
Okay.
And non-women-owned businesses, male-owned businesses, are welcome to attend, because the professional business education is so powerful. The connections with other successful business owners is so critical.
Yes.
So it's open to the community at whole. And we do have, frankly, many Middle Eastern members of our association, women-owned
okay.
businesses that are very successful
okay.
here in Michigan. And they come to us and partner with us because they either want women's business certification,
okay.
financing, business education.
Yes.
And many of them will be both attending our conference and 40th anniversary. But some of our vendors are actually Middle Eastern-owned companies.
You know, be honest with you, yes, probably there are some. But after this interview, after the information that we're going to get from you, you're going to have by far more. Tell me, is it select just for Michigan, or is open outside Michigan too?
Sadly, our reach is only for Michigan. What we do have, though, that this is important,
yes.
is we have sister organizations around the country.
Okay.
So if we're contacted and we can't serve you, you contact us for a loan or business training.
Certificate or
something,
anything.
Right, certification.
Yeah.
What we will do is we will refer you to the correct resource, because our job is to make sure that any businesses within our market get serviced. And so we will help you.
Great. You know, we broadcast in every state in the nation. So
excellent.
If you could give me a website, and we're going to put it in the screen so people could, you know, take it, or a phone number.
Absolutely,
if it's possible.
Our email address, you want our website?
Website is much
website,
better, because they could
me.
Go and get all the information.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Great Lakes, GreatLakesWBC
okay.
dot org is our website.
I see.
And our main number.
So it's the Great Lake B.
WBC.
WBC Woman Business Council. .org.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. And
we're
going to put
it
in a slide and a so people can take it and visit it.
Excellent. Yeah. And then our main number is 734-677-1400.
Okay, and we'll put this number in the screen.
Excellent.
Yeah, okay. So September 25th, okay, tell me what kind of program you're gonna have. Because when the people wanna, and especially now, if it's minority, you know,
yes.
you know, women or veteran or, you know, any minority, they wanna get information and what kind of program so they could, you know, should be interested to come to your conference or not.
So the kind of programming we're gonna have is we're going to have some workshops that are specially designed for different people in different industries. For example, for those who have products and want to do business with a major company,
okay.
a retail company,
uh-huh.
we have two different trainers coming in from other parts of the country who specialize in that, that were buyers for major corporations, and teach you how to get into Myers, how to get into Walmart and other companies,
yes.
but also how to get a higher ranking on the online e-commerce mm-hmm. platforms,
yes.
like Walmart.com, Amazon, and so mm-hmm. on. So
yes.
we're gonna help prepare you to be mm-hmm. successful in these areas.
Sure.
And for
and
the
it's
women
very important. Very, very important.
Very.
Yeah.
And for those that are women-owned businesses,
mm-hmm.
we recommend that we give you the Women's Business Enterprise certification that you apply for it, because we can do introduction then to
yes.
these companies, to
sure.
their supplier diversity professionals.
Mm-hmm.
We will also be having some opportunities to network with corporate purchasing representatives.
Uh-huh.
We will have a beautiful awards luncheon where we will also have an amazing keynote. Miss Deborah Gardner, who was an Olympic swimmer.
Oh, nice.
And yeah. she has become very successful at leadership training.
Okay.
And it's going to provide some of that for our
Good.
Attendees.
Yeah.
So it's a beautiful action-packed day of opportunity, of learning, of networking, everything that a small business owner needs.
Sure, yeah. Is there a ticket to buy?
There are tickets to buy,
okay.
and you can get it online on our website. In fact,
you could go to the website and get the ticket and everything. Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. Michelle, as I mentioned, there is a lot of, we are ethnic minority, and Michigan is multi-part of all ethnic minorities, and we are very proud of it, you know.
Exactly.
To certify the business as minority, can you give me some, like, 1 minute detail? Because there's a lot of them, you know. And a lot of them, not just in Michigan, but nationwide.
Absolutely.
And that could help them.
So, we personally do not do minority ethnic certification, but
okay.
we know
women,
who does
you know, let's
country.
Talk about women, veteran, and
but
you know.
We do women's own
okay.
certification, and so basically you have to be majority owned,
okay,
controlled,
okay,
managed by a woman or women,
okay,
and for the minority certification is the same. Now understand too, we know who all our partners are for veterans, for minority certification. So if you want a different certification, we can refer you to the right organization.
Great. What's the process? It's full of application?
It is.
Is there a charge for that? And
There is a nominal charge
okay,
for that,
yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
but it's an amazingly valuable marketing tool that helps you to get business.
I see.
And it's an online application, and we do ask a lot of information because we have to be able to
sure, absolutely.
Verify.
To make sure, you know, yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. So what else beside this you offer?
We have business education program.
Because for 40 years, I know you did a lot of things and you established a lot of things. To give me a couple of minutes about the establishment and what kind of program and up to date.
Our goal is to provide you with what you need to grow.
Okay.
And what isn't you're not getting from banks and from other organizations. So that's why we do Women's Business Certification. That's why we do a group mentoring program for women and coaching,
mm-hmm.
business education workshops. Most of our programs, with the exception of certification and our events, are all free of charge.
Wow.
And many of them are online. So if you can't attend a webinar, they're always recorded. They're always there available for you to download and watch
yes.
yourself. So we try to make as much business education information available to you as we can.
I see. We talked about a lot of your program and all that. And our viewer, majority of our viewers are Middle Eastern.
Yes.
Middle Eastern American community, if it's in Michigan, all over the nation. And you said you have some, you know.
Oh, mostly. Yeah.
Give me a message to them in 1 minute. What was the importance of them joining you and attending the conference on September 25th?
Well, the real benefit of attending is that we have 40 years of experience of working with women business owners to help them to grow and succeed, and we will make that all available to you. Additionally, we have a rather large constituency of our 2,000 plus businesses that are from the Middle Eastern community. And we're fortunate to live in Michigan because there is a large Middle Eastern community. We work very closely with some of the Chaldean Chamber and with Access and some of the other organizations around here who are involved in business development. And we partner with them, we sponsor for them, they sponsor us. And so we're a very close community together.
Great. And thank you so much for all the information. I know there's a lot of women-owned businesses, they don't have that information. And with you, and probably they're gonna come to your conference so they could learn more and more. So thank you so much for this. And thanks
for
your service.
Thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.
Sure. Dear viewer, that was my interview with Michelle Richard. She is the founder of the Great Lake Businesswoman Council. For 40 years, she did a lot of important events and all that. And a lot of Middle Eastern community, women-owned, they are part of them. And if you're not, please, I want you to join them. Because by joining them, you're going to see the benefit they have. And you could, you know what, benefit from that too. And especially in registration for the businesswoman, for the woman-owned, and for the, if they need finance, if they need training, you know, about the business and all that, they are there to grow your business, but the small business we're talking, to grow your business. So I encourage you to come to September the 25th to the nice event, and we're gonna put the website in a screen, so you could go to this website, get the ticket, and go there, because I'm pretty sure you're gonna benefit a lot from going there and hear all the information and how could you grow your business. Thanks for watching and good night.